Socks seems so simple. Simple thing for prosthetic patients to have, that they're going to give a bag full of socks when they get their prosthetic, different levels of socks. Seems simple, but it's vitally important. And honestly, one of the most frustrating things patients deal with is regulating socks correctly. So why is it so important? It's important because the prosthetist is going to make a prosthetic socket on a give that fits the patient on the day that it was made. And as the patient progresses and becomes more functional walking, they're going to tend to taper and shrink and shape their residual limb. It's not going to be the same size. As that occurs, something's got to fill the void between the two. On a given day, someone may actually have eaten too much salt the night before and swell up some, and you have to take some socks off. So remember, the human body is a dynamic, organic machine that's changing every day. And socks are the only way that you can adapt the fit of a fixed socket to the patient on that given day. Now, there are different types of socks. This is a one-ply sock. This sock happens to have a hole in the end. That is if they're using a pin system or a lanyard system. Without a system like that, a vacuum suction system, you can just have a straight sock without a hole in the end. The hole is very important for a pin system, which we'll look at when we put the socket on. There are three-ply socks, and there are different types of socks. And there are different manufacturers of socks. So what you're going to get many times is, with your particular prosthetist, a chart that shows the different socks and what the thicknesses are. Red will mean a certain thickness, gray, green, blue. You need to understand with your socks what that means, because it doesn't matter how many socks you're wearing. It matters the ply of sock you're wearing. So if you're wearing three socks that are one ply each, that's very different than wearing three socks that are three ply each. That three ply is going to give you nine ply sock, or three times what you're doing with the other volume. You have to understand that you want to wear the least number of socks to get the greatest ply, so you're not piling up any more socks than you have to. Now, with this idea of regulating socks and it ongoing every day, means that you have to take socks with you. No amputee should leave the home without having at least a one-ply and a three-ply sock, either in their back pocket, rolled up in their glove box, or in multiple different places. Because if you're out in the middle of the day and you begin to lose fit, right, it becomes very uncomfortable and dangerous fairly quickly. And you need to be able to adjust those socks to get the fit right again, and so you can continue going through your day. Shoes, very important to the prosthetic wearer. A lot of people think they get their prosthetic device, whatever shoe they stick on there is going to do well. That's really not the case. You want to have the right shoe for the job. And that is many times a cross-trainer type shoe. That means a shoe that has the right heel-to-toe drop-off. Prosthetic feet are usually set at about a 3/8 inch drop-off from heel to toe. And cross-trainers are about in that family. At the same light, there are a strong upper that can lace around or Velcro around the prosthetic foot to keep it in place. And the base is wide and stable and has a shock-absorbing heel. That way it won't slip when the patient's walking, and it'll keep them more stabilized through the gait cycle. So this is the right shoe. However, a couple of things are important. Patients many times will go in and be fit on their first day with a particular pair of shoes, and then decide, I think I'm going to switch my shoes before I go start therapy or I go somewhere else. That's difficult to do if you haven't been trained and assessed each shoe to fit correctly. So let's go through some different shoes. There are different types of cross trainers and different types of sneakers that can work very well, have a different style of base. The good thing for the prosthetic we talked about, but it's also good for the residual or for the contralateral limb, because that can have a shoe that has a nice wide base, a shock absorbing sole. You can put inserts in it as well to give them the best base of support. However, I have lots of patients who say, hey, I only want to wear a dress shoe. And we're lucky now that we have dress shoes out there that have a rubberized, vibrant sole. It's basically a sole of a tennis shoe in a dress shoe. The thing you have to look for is a low to heel to toe relationship. They make that shoe as level as possible, and a stable enough upper to hold the prosthetic foot in place. As far as for the contralateral limb, it has to have a wide enough toe box that you're not going to cause compression of the foot in the shoe. So, here's an older shoe where you see a thicker heel, which is a very rigid heel. This prosthetic would be tipped forward, and every time the patient steps, it would be a clunking wanting to slip the heel out to the side. So we kind of want to stay away from rigid, soled, high-heeled shoe. It's just not going to fit well. A more stable shoe is a lower. Now, if we go to the opposite extreme, and we say more of a dockside, very popular shoe, can also lace up, get in place, but has very limited drop-off from heel to toe. this type of foot will, or shoe will work well, but you're gonna have to put some wedging underneath the heel to hold that foot up at a level position when they're walking. Now, putting the shoes on can be a trick unto itself. So shoehorns are really helpful to have around, because getting that shoe on in a foot that doesn't articulate or doesn't move up and down is a stiff thing, or is a difficult thing. And you want it to be a good snug fit. So standard shoehorns are great. These extra long shoehorns are really great if you can't bend all the way over, but get down to getting that foot in place. Now, the last shoe that people talk about is boots. Difficulty with boots is a couple of things. One, with no zippers on the side, it's very hard to get the prosthetic foot in, if not impossible. Second of all, there's a large heel-to-toe relationship, which means often the whole prosthetic and everything is tipped forward. That makes it an unstable. And the third issue is maybe weight. You've got a fairly heavy weight hanging at the end of a pendulum of the prosthetic. If you do feel strongly about using a boot, a couple of things are important. Make sure that boot can zip down the side so you have the chance of getting the prosthetic foot in. Make sure the heel-to-toe relationship is as low and level as possible so that you have the best chance of getting a what we call a vertical pylon. So let's talk about that. Vertical pylon is important because that's going to establish how you know whether you've got the right shoes for you. If you look at this pylon, it is vertical. That means that device is set up with balance. If it's leaning back, it becomes unstable to fall backwards. If it's leaning forward, it's going to make the knee want to buckle and then the device to potentially collapse. You always want a pylon vertical. So if you get a new pair of shoes, you put them on the prosthetic foot, set the foot up on a table, and make sure that that pylon is vertical. If the pylon is leaning posteriorly, then you're going to have need to put some wedging underneath the heel to level it up. If it's leaning forward in a high-heeled shoe or a boot, it really is not something you can use. It's going to be too unstabling to the device and very difficult for the patient to walk. So, picking the right shoe is really important to the patient to get the right fit and the best walk. Once you've picked a pair of shoes that works, it's really important also to stay with it. I would suggest to patients a lot of times for at least 2 to 3 months when you're first getting started, don't change the shoes. Because even a good shoe fit will change the feel of the walk, and you want to master your walking control first. Then you can look at various different shoes that you can potentially change into over time. The last issue is there are things, what's called adjustable ankles. So prosthetically, if you get an adjustable ankle foot or a prosthetic foot, that can adjust to different heel heights. That is an option. The benefit is you can do that with the different shoes. The negative is that it's not going to give you the same amount of energy return or stability that comes from a non-articulated ankle foot. And so you have to make the right choice for you and the right shoes for you. Thanks for watching, and we hope that you found this information helpful. This video is part of a series on prosthetic rehabilitation, ranging from managing the residual limb after amputation and progressing to running with a prosthesis. We encourage you to view our other videos in this series and to share them as well. You can find them on our YouTube channel at youtube.com/missiongate. To stay up to date on our latest content, click the link in the corner to subscribe and be sure to like and share this video.